My brothers and sisters, losing a loved one is not easy. You suddenly lose your parent, or you might lose, for example, a child or a brother, especially when it is unexpected. Well, one might ask, what is meant by expected and unexpected? A very simple response is, if, for example, a person was terminally ill, they were not well for a while, people might expect that this person may pass away, so the preparation for it would have been a little bit more. Although people like that can live for years. So many times the doctors say you don't have much time, and then you end up living for longer than the doctor, subhanallah. And sometimes what happens is a person arrives at old age, and then they begin to prepare for death. Remember, if you have clocked 60, you definitely need to understand the Prophet ﷺ statement when he says, "A'maru ummati ma bayna 60 ila 70." The average lifespan of the members of my ummah is between 60 and 70 years. That would mean if you've clocked 60, you're already on the lower end of that average. You would be fortunate to get to 70, mashallah. You need to make peace with Allah. You need to constantly seek forgiveness and have hope in the mercy of Allah. Because seeking forgiveness alone, when you're doubting that forgiveness, is not good enough. Don't doubt forgiveness. You sought the forgiveness of Allah. You must make sure within your heart you firmly believe that Allah has forgiven me. And then if you clock 70, you need to know you're at the top end of that particular average, and therefore you are fortunate. Allah's given you a lot more time. You can bid farewell to your children and your family members in a better way. You can leave them in a good position. But when we say unexpected, someone suddenly goes, they're ill, and a few days later, a week later, 2 weeks later, they're gone. They did not have enough time to say goodbye to their family members, or to even prepare, or to even let them know some of the details of their lives. What this means is, recently, during the coronavirus, many people have lost their lives, and many of them have not even told their family members or their loved ones how they earn a living, who they owe money and who owes them money. So sometimes their family members struggle as a result of them not knowing anything about the income. Many families have actually gone to zero after the breadwinner was lost. May Allah grant us goodness. The point here is, number one, make sure you realize anyone can die at any time. Subhanallah. We've said this in the past, we're repeating it here, perhaps from a different angle. The angle is, have you and I prepared our loved ones for the day we're going to depart? Have you given them some important information? Have you left some important information about your living, your life, about the details they may need to know if you've passed away? Have you left it? If not, do it today. Start doing it now. You don't know how long you're going to live. I don't know either. They need to know a few of your passwords. Sorry to say that, but they need to know this. Some of your passwords. It might be a little embarrassment in some cases, but as a believer, it shouldn't be. We shouldn't be leading a life where we're embarrassed of something. May Allah grant us goodness and ease. So from this mimbar today, I'd like to remind myself and yourselves and everyone out there to say, please leave your loved ones with some details that will be necessary for them to know if you were to suddenly die. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a good death. Ameen.